You are on the most azim of akhlaq. Allahu Akbar Kabira. That is your job. That's your goal. That is your mission. That is your biggest response to any fitna and challenge out there in the world. Your own kirdar, one person at a time. First you have to fix your own kirdar, and then you have to influence whatever daira you have, whatever is your sphere of influence. Some of you may be able to expand that, some of you may be able to travel for that. Whatever your own sphere of influence is, whoever is in your reach, whoever you have the possibility of reaching. But you'll only be able to do that when you fix yourself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Qaf, وَلَا تُطِعْ مَنْ أَغْفَلْنَا قَلْبَهُ عَنْ ذِكْرِنَا. Do not listen, do not obey, do not follow. Man, that person, أَغْفَلْنَا, that we have made empty, قَلْبَهُ, his heart, and ذِكْرِنَا, from our remembrance, our zikr. Just a Quranic fatwa, that's the fatwa you should be worried about. We're going to be launching fatwas. Whatever this fatwa that's on you. And if our heart is empty of the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we see our prayers are empty of the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 90% of young men who pray will say that their sajda is empty of the zikr of Allah. Allahu Akbar Kabira. If sajda is empty of zikr of Allah, if namaz is empty of zikr of Allah, it means the heart must be empty of zikr of Allah. If heart is empty of zikr of Allah, then Allah Himself in Quran is telling the whole world, don't have to listen, follow, obey this person. And you have to articulate the sunnah way. There is no Lahore sunnah, there is no 2010 version of the sunnah. There's no new version of sunnah. You have to follow sunnah, the sunnah way. It's that simple. That's khuluqun azim. You don't need any new interpretation, new reformation, new moderation. Sunnah neither needs to be moderated, nor does it need to be reformed, nor does it to be adapted, nor does it need to be changed. Any such attempt at reform, moderation, change is just dilution and eventual dissolution of the sunnah. We need pure, original, khalis sunnah. That's the type of life we have to lead. That's the type of heart we have to have. That's the type of adab and akhlaq we have to have. That's the type of sifat, spiritual sifat we're supposed to have. Pure, true tawakkul, true sabr, true shukr, true muhammad ilahi, true ishq rasul. None of these can be diluted in any way whatsoever. And instead, what do we have? 100% nafs, 100% akal, and 100% jazbat. That's it. We know how to use our akal. At night, we know how to use our nafs. And somebody can come and ignite us with jazbat. Give me it. That's one of the ulama who called me said that we don't do something. So there are all these other people ki naujawanon ke jazbaat ko falan taraf lekar jayenge. All these random popular TV scholars in Pakistan now and pata nahi kya balai, right? And you guys get excited by that stuff as well. Hoo-ha, what do you call it? Shor sharapa, right? Fiery rhetoric and I don't know, flag waving and bench thumping. Yes, so you're like, your M&As are like that also, right? Allahu Akbar. ninety percent of the kids who go to those huge little, I don't know what are they, I don't even know what are they called. Wake up Pakistan. What is it? Takmeel Pakistan. I don't know what they're called. Wake up Pakistan, Takmeel Pakistan, Tehreek Pakistan. Sare baba karte aur raat jaakar 80% of them probably don't even wake up for Fajr the next morning. Look, even that the ulama view you this way. Mehta vaisik bhi baat sad ho gaya. The ulama think that you're just some jazbati kaum. You, the university students. That's how the ulama view you. As some merely jazbati kaum that's just going to go one way to the other way to the other way. Khair, you're Better than that, but you need to get achhe jazbaat. You need to have good jazbaat. And being jazba is not itself bad if you have the right jazba and you can sustain it. You need that. We need that. To the right jazba towards the sunnah. Don't try to discover the right response towards the cartoons. Try to discover inside yourself what should be the right jazba towards the sunnah. That's the real mission. If you can get the right jazba towards the sunnah, everything else will take care of itself automatically. A love for the sunnah, a respect for the sunnah, a reverence for the sunnah, an awe for the sunnah, a desire for the sunnah, a hirs for the sunnah. That's what we should feel. You should feel that I don't want any single adab, any single akhlaq, any single sifat, any single adai of the Prophet ﷺ to be unknown to me because I want to do amal on everyone. The Muhaddithin have even written how he walked. And they used to try to walk in that way. Allahu Akbar Kabira. Now let me tell you some secret that you guys don't seem to understand. These Muhaddithin, you can just try and understand it this way. You can only imagine that that human being who took such care in his whole life for 30, 40, 50, 60 years to walk like the Prophet ﷺ, you can only imagine how much care that human being would have taken to have a heart like the Prophet ﷺ's. Don't think there's some disconnect between the zahir and batin. That person who does ihtimam of sunnah will inevitably do ihtimam of both. And you know what your older generation loves to tell you? This age group from 40 to 60. Do teen aage hun mazrat unke saath. I'm not saying it in anybody specifically, personally here. But a large number of people from 40 to 60, they have what I call their pet maulvi. What they have is one zabardast maulvi story to give you. What is their one zabardast maulvi story? That's their excuse for abandoning the sunnah entirely. What's the maulvi story? What does that mean? The ek dari wala ne unke saath kya kiya hai zindagi mein ek dafa. But that's enough for them. That's nonsensical. Nobody, you cannot do, make any lifestyle choice on that basis. You will find in this world Pakistanis and Americans, both were good, both were bad. If you take one story, then I will have to make you abandon lums. I'll give you a story of one professor who teach neta. You should all leave lums because I can give you one lums professor story. Should I leave lums because you can give me one lums student story, one student who was a bad student? Should we all the faculty resign from lums? Have I represented to you my one clean shaven story? My one pen shirt story? It's ridiculous. It's childish. It's childish to think like that. And it's also incorrect. You're supposed to love the Prophet ﷺ and love his sunnah because it was his sunnah. Not because it was my sunnah or because it was some other Maulana sunnah or some other Sheikh's sunnah or some other Maulvi sunnah or some other student's sunnah or some other professor's sunnah. That has nothing to do with it. It's not their sunnah. It's his sunnah. Even if 10,000 people did something, it still means nothing to us. Because it wasn't their sunnah, it wasn't because of them you were supposed to do it in the first place anyway. People will go this far in this older generation, namaz ki ka fayda hai, wo to namazi hai. They'll bring out their namazi story as an excuse not to pray namaz, literally. They'll say, namaz ka kya fayda hai, falaan bandi namazi hai, aur falaan bandi jo namazi hai, usne falaan waqt mein falaan kaam kiya. Isne namaz ka koi fayda nahi. Allahu Akbar kabira. Aap namaz us falaan bandi ke kirdaar ki wajah se pad rahe the. Agar us wajah se pad rahe the, to aap beshak chhod dein, no problem, right? Agar aap namaz